Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1966, MAXIFS and MINIFS. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, two more functions that just came out in the February 2016 release of Office 365 are MAXIFS, plural, and MINIFS. This kind of reminds me of the new SUMIFS that was introduced a few versions ago. So we have a database here where we have a rep, a class, and then a rating. If we want to figure out the highest rating that Andy got for the pivot table class, we would use equal MAXIFS, plural. Now, just like SUMIFS and COUNTIFS and AVERAGEIFS, you want to specify the numeric field first. So I'll choose that. I'll press F4 to lock that down. And then the first criteria range. The first criteria range is we're going to look through all of the sales reps over in column A, press F4, and see if that's equal to Andy. Now, right here, I'm going to press F4 one, two, three times to make sure that we're always pointing at column E, but the row is allowed to change from 4 to 5 to 6. Next up, we're going to look through all of the classes in column B, F4, see if that's equal to pivot table. And here I'll press F4 twice. One, two times to lock it down to just the row, and we'll see that Andy scored, his highest score was a 5, and Bet 4, Charlie 2, and then 3. All right, so that's the new MAXIFS function. The MINIFS function is going to be very similar. Copy it down here, I'll do a Control H, change every occurrence of MAX to MIN, replace all. Close. We'll take a look, exact same thing, but here it's looking for the min instead of the max. All right, so that is a total of 6 new functions that were added in February 2016 to Office 365. All right, our next video is going to talk about how you can get these functions if you have Office 365, and it's a lot more confusing than you think. Use that icon up there in the top right-hand corner to jump to that video. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.